Hey, knife lovers, what's up? All right, back at you once again. Back at you. So, I'm doing a video here, and I'll talk about these two watches I got. Okay, so I got two Wittnauer watches, okay? This one right here. Last time when I showed it, it wasn't running. It's running now, but it's got a little problem with it. We still have to go see the watch maker. You know, not the repair guy, but the watchmaker. See, because it moves inside of the case. This is the case, the dial case, and this is the dial inside. The dial moves around, which the dial has the movement connected to it, so the movement is moving around inside the watch, and that's not good. So I got to get that, I guess it's an insert or something that goes inside there. Probably needs replacing, so. But it's running, though, and it's got the right time. You know, in my part of the world, it's actually 17 minutes to 12, okay? Approximately. And this is another one. This one has 15 minutes to 12. 15 minutes to 12, and this one's a little... couple minutes behind it, but you can see that second hand is ticking second by second. It's a quartz moving good. And this here, this is my baby right here. She in the process of changing the date right now. So yeah, it's ticking. FUBU, you know, for those who don't know, FUBU means for us, by us, made by Wittnauer. Okay, this is a Wittnauer. Okay, this is the real McCoy. This is not something you buy at the Chinese store. Okay, I mean, Chinese sellers might sell them, but they don't make them. All right, it's a Wittnauer. You might just see the Wittnauer under the FUBU. Just buy Wittnauer FUBU. So. They had a black version and a white version. The white had a more dressy look, and the black one was more sporty. So yeah, these watches needed batteries in it. And like I say, this one going, I can still wear it like it is, but eventually sooner, and more likely sooner than later, it needs to see a watch maker to get that insert put in there. And he may have to order. And they may make one. So that's the next move. And this wouldn't be an official Jimbo the First video without showing some knives. So we got the legendary, as I always like to say, the Luzon. Won't even fit into the film. It's so big. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. This is one right here. You've seen many times. You see it again. And again, this is one of my oldies but goodies right here. The buck knife. I'm on EDC a lot. I EDC this today. You know. Yeah. It's a buck. It's got a number on it somewhere. But it's one of those plastic handle knives. You know what I'm saying? It's a nice knife. Nice little buck. 420 HC, made in USA. And we got this beast, okay? This is Jimmy Slash's influence on me right here. Yeah, Jimmy Slash influenced me in a good way. Very good way, because I am very pleased with this. See that? Beast. They call this the 4MAX Scout. Yeah, Cold Steel gave it that name. Cold Steel, R10A, Taiwan. You probably can't see it because it ain't clear. It's a real foggy camera here. But yeah, it's the 4MAX Scout. Great big old blade. Yeah, it's a big boy. This is one. You can EDC this. Big. EDC it. And you know, I mean, because I know there's people out there that write, don't have money to buy the knives all the time, right? So, but Cold Steel, you know, they just generous people, right? They buy, they make stuff that everybody can afford, you know? This knife is like $10. Sharp, too. They make them in China now. Make it out of 5CR. 5CR, 15 MOV. Made in China. This is the Kudo. Yeah, the Kudo. You see the box. The Kudo, right? You see the stats on there if you can. It says 4 1/4 inch blade. It's a big blade. 5CR 15 MOV. Weighs 2.7 ounces. 2 millimeters thick. Overall handle is 5 3/4. That's what all this stuff down here is saying. Okay. Then we got this one. Okay. And you might say, well, what's the difference? Well, this is the light. This is the light right here. And this is the regular Kudo. See, it's got their ring back on it. This is the locking mechanism. Right, it's got a lock on it. Whereas this is just a standard slip joint. So this is called the Kudo Light. Same size blade, same size handle, same blade material. Just did it's lighter, I guess, because it doesn't have the lock on it in that ring. But they call this the Kudo Light. Okay. And this is cheaper than the Kudo. The Kudo Light is a little less expensive. So if you don't have any, if your money is funny and you want to still buy a knife, you know what I mean? You can take care of that fix with buying a Kudo. Matter of fact, I ordered two more. I like them that much. It's a shit. And these are used. These are real user knives right here. You know what I'm saying? And that lock is strong. It's not gonna give. Where's this one? This right here. I fold this baby and then nick my finger. But it's a slip joint. See that? It's a half stop. One just a little bit past it. Snaps got a lot of snap. Walk and talk, as they call it. You know what I'm saying? So this can do that. And it's got good retention. It ain't going to pop out, snap out. You got to pull it with the pull. Okay? Not a bad looking knife. And it's inexpensive. Made out of the good plastic that Cold Steel has got their proprietary blend to make it. You know, this day stuff. You know what I mean? They know what they're doing over there. You know, they got the PhDs in this stuff, you know? And then, just the little Luzon. Here's his bigger brother. That's the Luzon. Then we got the Voyager. This Voyager is no joke. This is per EDC with that true self-defense element to it. You know what I'm saying? Can defend yourself with this if you had to. You wouldn't want to, but if you had to, this is the one you want to have right here. You know, this is you know. And then, like I said, a lot of people be and complain. You know what I mean? Be, you know what the B for, right? They be and complain about the pocket clip being too tight, right? I just take mine and bend it up a little bit. See that? And I don't have no problem. Okay, no problem at all. You know, and that's fixed. This one right here. I haven't gotten around to it yet, but I'm going to contact Cold Steel probably when this COVID stuff go away and see if they can't give me another pocket clip for this. And then I'm going to take this original one and I'm going to sand this portion down so it won't have that lip on there. You know, just slide right in on the pants, you know, but I'll have an original one to always change back on there and just in case I ever decide to sell it or something along them line. But right now I don't have no knives I can part with. But well, I might have a few junk knives I could, but you know, none of the Cold Steels or anything like it. I don't really see that happening anytime soon. See, but yeah. Now I like knives that you can open with one hand, and this is something I got here. You know, also like the polished ones too. And well, we got some of them somewhere around as well, but this is the one I'm showing for now. Okay, and you see pocket clip. Pocket clip. This one comes with two pocket clips. The polished one doesn't. Polished one only comes with one pocket clip. But yeah, this one comes with two pocket clips. I got mine on the right side because I like to live right. Nah, exactly. I'm right-handed. But yeah, this, you can open this with one hand. You know what I'm saying? It can be done. You can actually close it with one as well. Take it like that. Stab it down. Yeah, so you take it. There you go. And you know what I'm saying? This is a beast. This is what you call the beast. Okay. We can get it all in the frame there. So we got a little family of cold steel right here. You know? It's a little family of cold steel. You know. And then we got one buck. You know? Little family of cold steel. You know what I mean? Got the spotter, the Luzon, medium, as they call it, the medium, but I call it the little brother. We got the big brother, the Luzon Large. We got the 4 Max. And we got the Voyager. And we got the Kudo Light. No, that's the Kudo right here. This is the Kudo, my bad. I said Kudo. This is the Kudo Light. With no ring on it, just and no lock. And then we got the Voyager. That's the Voyager Large. They have an extra large. I got that too, but it ain't with me right now. And these are the boxes for the Kudos. Like I said, you can get both of these for less than $20. You can go on Amazon to get them, both of them, for less than $20. And they ship them to your house for less than $20. You can get them from Blade HQ. Then they got this. Always keep a buck around. Buck or two, you know what I'm saying? If you can't get a couple hundred of them, then get at least have a few of them. So I got one buck right now, which is better than having none. You know. And back to this is Wittnauer. So yeah, you see it's closing in on 12 o'clock. We're closing in on a new day. By the time this video uploads, it'll be the 16th. Okay? As it says on this watch, the 16th. It'll be the 16th. Peace, take care. And once again, we're gonna take a look at these big old spotted here. And Luzon and little Luzon. See the knives. Okay. The boxes. And then the watches that I'm under feature. You know what I'm saying? And both of these watches. I had this one first. But I had this for about 20 years. This 20-year-old watch. This one right here. It's about 25 years old right here. Yeah, this one about 22 years. I had this about 22 years. And I had this one about 25 years. So yeah, they've been with me a minute. You know what I'm saying? So take care, peace, and adios amigos.